If you want to stop wasting your cellular data on your iPhone, here are some easy tips. Number one, let's open up the settings app. Scroll down and tap general.
General.
And then tap background app refresh.
Background app refresh.
Now at the top of the screen, you'll see background app refresh again. Let's tap on that. And then just make sure that you selected Wi-Fi here instead of Wi-Fi and cellular data. Background app refresh lets apps download new content in the background of your iPhone, and that can use cellular data if you let your iPhone do it.
Right, there's no limit to this either. So yep. Some apps will go crazy and just use all your cellular data. And nowadays, more and more plans have limits on the amount of high-speed data you can use. Let's talk about our next setting, which is it's a touching story
that goes along with this. It's turning off personal hotspot when not in use. So you go back to the main page of the settings app and tap on personal hotspot. Turn this off. I plugged my iPhone into my wife's computer and I left personal hotspot on, and my iPhone got tethered to her computer, and I wake up in the morning, all my data's gone. First day of the month, all gone. It was unbelievable, and I was like, oh, that's annoying.
Yeah.
So just make sure that switch is turned off when you're not using personal hotspot. If you like that story, give this video a like. If you didn't like the story, leave a comment down below and tell me why. Next, let's go to settings cellular. So back to the main page of the settings app.
Swipe here.
Swipe there. And tap cellular. So if you scroll down here, you can see a list of your apps which use the most data, as well as the period that you've been tracking how much data they're using, which is a little bit interesting if you want to kind of budget.
You could do some math So I did the math, and over the last 100 and something days, I've used 7.6 gigabytes cellular data, which averaged out to 2.1 gigabytes of data per month. Now, I'm a tech guy. That's not a lot. I was surprised, but it's because I'm home a lot. I work from home, pandemic.
Yeah. And it's really good to see if you're spending too much on your cell phone plan. Like if you only need 2 gigabytes per month and you're paying for an unlimited plan, you can probably downgrade. But if we scroll to the top of the screen here, here's a tip. Tap on cellular data options and then tap on data mode. And if you have a 5G iPhone, iPhone 12 line, the iPhone 13 line, which is going to be coming out soon, just make sure that allow more data on 5G is not selected.
Yeah. Also, it's probably going to save some battery life, too. Yeah. Just, you don't need to be...
5G infrastructure isn't there yet. And if you don't have a 5G iPhone, turn on low data mode when you're running low on data. So, like, I get messages from Verizon saying you have 500 megabytes left, you have 100 megabytes left. At that point, I would turn on low data mode and just kind of preserve
That's interesting. I suppose I would get those messages, too, if I ever used any data at all.
If you ever accidentally left a personal hotspot overnight, you might get those.
If I had a significant other, it might be a problem.
Yep.
Yep. Are you happy you married her?
Yeah.
In spite of that?
Well, it wasn't her fault. It was my fault for leaving Hotspot on.
Oh,
it wasn't her computer. All right, let's go back again and back to setting cellular one more time. And if we scroll all the way down.
Oh, dear.
We're looking for Wi-Fi assist.
Yeah, that's what it is. So automatically use cellular data when Wi-Fi connectivity is poor.
This is especially useful if you're using public Wi-Fi a lot where the connections aren't as strong. Like home Wi-Fi is probably strong. Don't need to necessarily worry about this. Mm-hmm. Public Wi-Fi, Wi-Fi assist is going to kick in more often. So just be cognizant of that and
you
may want to turn it off. All right, I think we've had enough time in settings. Let's go back to the main page of settings.
Yeah.
And we're going to go to privacy.
All right, so privacy is under battery.
Yep, we're going to scroll down to analytics and improvements. Tap on that. So when Share iPhone and Watch Analytics is turned on, your iPhone sends data to Apple to help them improve their products. This can use cellular data when they do.
Yep, and if you're not convinced, just look through all the logs. All of this is being sent to Apple. And yes, they're not the smallest files either, if you look through it.
Yeah.
So, yeah, be careful.
Save a little bit of cellular data, turn off that switch. Also, save a little bit of battery life at the same time.
Yes. See you later. This will also turn off. Wow.
There you go, all at once. Next, let's talk about closing out of your apps, which can sometimes be controversial.
Right. Keep watching this video. So, apps are supposed to close when you swipe up from the middle of the screen, you hold your finger there, you swipe them off the top of the screen, or if you have an iPhone with a home button, you double tap the home button, swipe them off the top of the screen. They're supposed to close within a few seconds. Usually they do, but if they don't, apps can get stuck in this kind of zombie mode where they're just using your CPU, using data, doing stuff they're not supposed to do. So in iPhone utopia world, which is where a lot of people live, you should never have to do this. But in the real world, it's like wearing the seatbelt in your car. You should never have to wear your seatbelt, but it's a good idea to wear it anyway.
Yeah, that's kind of expert insight you get here. Subscribe to this channel.
Expert.
For more.
Worked at the Apple store.
For more of that, yeah. Next tip might sound obvious, but use Wi-Fi instead of cellular data when it is available.
Right, so tap on settings and then look. If there's a network name like Meowie 5G or whatever yours is next to Wi-Fi, you're connected to Wi-Fi. Yeah,
generally. However, I have noticed that when my Wi-Fi cuts out sometimes, I'll still see the bars and it'll still say it's connected, but it'll say no internet connection underneath the name of my Wi-Fi network.
Right.
So just be aware of that. If you think you're having some slow internet issues, it might actually, it might just not be connected.
Well, it is connected to the Wi-Fi, but the Wi-Fi router is then not connected to the internet, which indicates a cable modem problem.
Okay.
Yes. Is there any nothing of that, to do with is the Wi-Fi
any
router.
Of that, any of that useful?
What you said or what I said?
Either.
Maybe.
Is it relevant at all to this video, the no internet connection?
Well, that's when cellular data assist would kick in, because you're connected to Wi-Fi, and then it would use cellular data instead. Mm-hmm. Like, if you're able to use data and it says no internet connection and Wi-Fi, then it's using cellular data.
Our next tip is available in certain apps and is limiting the bandwidth that app can use.
Right. So Facebook, for instance, YouTube, have the ability to say, I don't want to stream videos or view photos in full HD. I'm okay on my little screen watching in less than HD, which is going to save a significant amount of data because videos take up the most data. Streaming video can burn through your data. So for instance, in the YouTube app, and obviously we can't go through every single app, but YouTube, you can then tap on your little face in the upper right-hand corner of the screen, then tap settings, then tap video quality preferences. Then you have a choice to affect this on mobile networks or on Wi-Fi. So in this case, it's on mobile networks. And then instead of auto, you could choose data saver. And then on Wi-Fi, who gives a crap?
Yeah.
I would just do auto. So that's actually a good idea to do. On Facebook, for instance, there's another one. For Facebook, the setting is under more. And then at the bottom, you can then go to settings and privacy, and then settings. So I recommend hitting the magnifying glass in the upper right-hand corner, and then tapping in the search settings and just typing in data, because it's kind of a convoluted menu they have here. Then tap on media, and then you can choose the video quality, like data saver, a lower, or for autoplay, and this is the one I like to change. We don't want to autoplay video on mobile. So we just say on Wi-Fi only. There you go.
There you go. Save some data. And if there's another app that you use a lot of cellular data on, you know, do a Google search. See if there's an option to do that.
Right. If you can't find an option and that app is out of control, you can turn off cellular data for that app specifically.
Yeah, so let's go into the settings app, so I'm going to do that.
Mm-hmm. Settings. Then we're going to go back to cellular. And then you'll notice that there are these little switches next to every single app. If you want to turn one off,
tap the switch.
Tap the switch.
There you go.
There you go.
Simple as that.
Right. Next is a new feature in iOS 15. So I'm going to tap back to settings. I'm going to go up to the top, tap on my name. Yep. Tap on iCloud. Then tap on iCloud backup. Backup over cellular. What the heck are they doing this for?
Don't do that.
You do not need to back it up over cellular. Just use Wi-Fi.
I think what they're trying to do is, oh, 5G is available now. This will be super fast and cool for you.
Nope.
But it's going to use all of your data.
Yeah, and it's not going to be super fast unless you're plugging your iPhone in outside, because the 5G that's super fast doesn't go through walls. Yeah. 5G is not all it's cracked up to be. So I would definitely turn that off.
Our next tip is related to the photo settings. Let's go back to the main page of the settings app.
Little tip here. I'm just going to press and hold on the little iCloud thing and then come all the way back down to settings.
Yeah, and then scroll down and tap on photos.
Photos. Now we're going to tap on cellular data. They keep changing this menu in here. So you can turn off cellular data, which is kind of what I recommend. I mean, let's restrict the updates to Wi-Fi. It's kind of like iCloud backup. Let's just do it over Wi-Fi. But be especially careful of unlimited updates here. And Apple says this may cause you to exceed your cellular data plan.
And it's on by default, huh?
I think it is.
Yikes.
Yeah. Yikes. So turn that off too.
Yep.
Are some of these companies trying to get you to use more data?
Yes.
I would say so.
They sure are.
Yes, they are.
Those are some tips to stop wasting your data on your iPhone. Thanks for watching. Give this video a thumbs up if you enjoyed. Leave a comment down below with any of your questions, or if you have a tip for us, please let us know. And
Subscribe, join. But also, you know, like leaving a comment, that doesn't use much data. So
yeah, easy.
There you go. It's not a waste.